Visuals are everything.
I wasn't expecting that question.
The marriage of music and film goes together like a dang peanut butter cup. You know, separately they can be good, but together they help each other reach their full potential. We've talked about album covers, rollouts, album sequencing, but I wanted to talk about something outside of the album that's just as essential. I've seen people say that music videos are basically just a promotional tool, that music is better without them, and that they limit what we can imagine the music to be. I can understand that. I mean, Nights by Frank Ocean has a music video that I created in my head with all the memories I have associated with that song. But otherwise, I disagree. Sometimes I want to see with my eyes. I was thinking about this recently after listening to Leave the Door Open by Bruno Mars and Anderson .Paak. I thought it was cool. I was like, this is a pretty good song, yeah. Then I saw the music video and it just hit me. Why did it sound 1,000 times better? The colors, the smoothness, this guy's glasses and how it reflects in the light. The vibes, man. The sheer amount of vibes. Suddenly I was listening to the song like Binky in that one episode of Arthur. I feel like this happens a lot. A music video just makes a song click. I swear half of Playboi Carti's songs sound garbage to me until I see them in a meme. I'm like, hold on. This is fire. Is that a baby riding a hyena? Oh my god. Of course, there are the lazy music videos that are slapped together to quickly push a song and then never be talked about again. But the music video is a way to take a song and help people visualize it in a way they would have maybe never done without it. It can tell a story. It can help people connect to it even more. It can turn the song into a moment that lives forever. We can watch it decades later and get an idea of not only the song and its artistry, but it's a time capsule for that era. It's a chance to create something truly iconic. The amount of dance moves, fashion choices, and memes that have been immortalized through the music videos for their song. What if we never had that video? Where would we be right now? In a less mischievous world, that's where. And that's not a world I want to live in. But what makes a good, iconic music video?
Michael Jackson for Thriller.
Beyonce had one of the best videos of all time. One of the best videos of all time.
Okay, but before we got here, what made music videos such a big deal in the first place that Kanye would storm the stage and change his career forever? I think videos hit so different because a lot of the time, listening to music is something we do passively. When you're listening to a song, at least when I am, I'm not always giving 100% of my attention to the song, okay? I'm not listening to Migos like,
I can hear the intricacies of the trap hi-hats.
Like I'm Anthony Fantano or something, bro. I'm sorry. I'm just vibing out most of the time. We listen to songs in cars, on drives, at parties, while we're on walks, while studying or working, crying in the shower, we can be busy. There's a reason why you'll see most artists drop their new single with a music video. And that's because a music video demands your complete attention, just like we are. No, but this video did make everyone feel something. Everyone feels something. I think that's what's so great about music videos. There are no real rules besides it has to complement the song and it has to make the viewer feel something. If you're making a movie, you gotta have a good script. You gotta have good actors. You gotta have like a three-act structure. Come to set and Air Bud isn't cooperating. You're like, why are they still making these movies? How am I making one of them? A music video just has to take a song and try to elevate it in some way. Sounds have distinct visuals to them already. Like when you hear this, you're not imagining like a beautiful, serene environment. Sounds have colors and vibes to them that can be translated on screen. You can hear a song and be like, this sounds like how McDonald's Sprite tastes. Or this sounds like skydiving naked. Or this one sounds like how it feels when Air Bud dunks on you. Just depressing. So you can incorporate those feelings into a music video. This sounds like a summer day, so make the visuals match that. I feel like Tyler, the Creator's visuals, especially for the new album, all have a very distinctly him visual style. And by the way, that rollout, I feel like you should be able to mute the video and still get an idea of what the vibe of the song could be. But not always. Sometimes it's better to juxtapose that joint. But it's about how the colors, the visuals, and the energy impacts you. Or a combination of all of them. One way to have the visuals match the energy of the song is with a performance, some choreography. And that's an easy one, because what does music make you want to do more than anything? It makes you want to freaking move. Music make you lose control. the most common one, but this is also how we get the most iconic of dance moves. This is the artist singing or dancing, rapping, jamming out with the rest of the band. This really shows their personality and it gives them a chance to shine. But what elevates it is what's happening around them. What's the costume design? What does the location or set look like? What's the choreography? What's really gonna stick in people's heads? Weird camera moves, interesting color, or striking imagery. Britney Spears with the crazy concepts of like the spies and all that around the dancing. The 2000s just had iconic videos, man. The weirdness of Gangnam Style is what made it such a hit in the US. K-pop in general will be doing the most with the choreography. Like, oh my goodness. This is 17, this is like 50 dudes doing the same thing at once. They go all in, I gotta give it to them. Hotline Bling is what it is because this man doesn't know how to dance. That's what makes it so great. He's one of us. This is what we're doing on the dance floor. I'm sorry, BTS. I'm not doing none of that. I'm on the dance floor doing this, okay? The amount of memes this single video generated is ridiculous. People still use this template to this day. And it doesn't have to be the artist actually performing this song. Gorillaz created animated characters for themselves and a whole world for people to get attached to. You can have interpretive dancers to tell a story through dance like Sia, or you can just have Christopher Walken dance like Spike Jonze did for his video. This dude Spike Jonze, anytime this man directs anything with music, he is goated. Every music video he did, in his movie Her, all the music placements in that movie are my favorite part. Directed an advertisement for Apple with FKA Twig, and I've seen that ad like 100 times. That ad made me feel things, man. I don't know why. Just how it starts out all gray and dreary and then the music plays. About it till it's over. And the colors are just so great, and the dancing was apparently all reals. None of this is CG. This ad is one of my favorite music videos of all time. Speaking of music video adjacent things, Bo Burnham literally just made like 30 music videos in his new special. And you can see the colors and energy are all different and fit the music perfectly. So there's a lot of ways to do it. But when it comes to creating a performance within a music video and capturing your full attention, no one is doing it better than the sets, costumes, choreography for videos like Beat It, Smooth Criminal, Bad, Rock With You, Come On Bro. Billie Jean single-handedly broke the color barrier on MTV. They were not playing black artists on there before this, even though we already had legends. Billie Jean broke the color barrier and then Thriller just smashed it wide open. This video literally turned music videos into a serious art form by itself. You're not playing Thriller. Okay, it's just not happening. This is back when they played stuff on MTV other than Ridiculousness. But what I think is ridiculous is when people are like, I miss when MTV played only music videos. We need to go back to that time. Who really wants to turn on their TV to watch a music video anymore? It's 2021, you old man. But anyways, we all know every single Michael Jackson video is peak. But he didn't just master the performance part. He blurred the line between music video and short film. And that's because a lot of his videos have basically, if you want to see Drake as a mob boss trying to save his girl from some other thing, you're going with the narrative music video. Most of R&B has the stories, which I love, where the video is telling the same story of the girl and trying to get the girl back, man, and get to it. There's two types of narrative music videos. One where the video and the song itself are telling the story, and another where they literally cut away from the song to tell the story. You're listening and suddenly Quavo was acting. Like, I'm trying to hear the song and you keep cutting to this random story that is honestly bad. What is even going on? The one time I love it is when they do a full visual album. Prince literally created a whole movie for Purple Rain. Beyonce with Lemonade and Black is King. She's basically expected to do stuff like that now. But if it's not like that kind of narrative, I prefer when the music video's directing is telling the story that the song also.
First rule in this world, baby, don't pay attention to anything you see in the news.
A lot of videos combine multiple things like narrative and performance. Lady Gaga was having crazy performance narrative videos. Alicia Keys had the same guy in multiple videos. It was like an overarching story in multiple music videos, which I love. The Weeknd has a lot of overarching characters and themes through his music videos for multiple albums. Daft Punk was telling these stories through animation. I think a bad music video is when they literally take the lyrics and the visuals are word for word what the lyrics are saying as they're saying it. I got a girl on my right and a girl on my left and a girl at the top and a girl over there. It's like, all right, I could have just imagined this in my head. I think a good music video leaves a little bit of something up to interpretation. In other words, the experimental or concept video, or the what did I just watch video. Most of these videos are also telling a story in some way, shape, or form. They're just doing it in a way less obvious way. It's basically the A24 of the music world. It's like at the end of The Lighthouse, you saw it and you were like, oh, I get it. You didn't actually get it, you just didn't want to seem stupid. The world of the song doesn't have to really make sense in these. Things happen for reasons you don't understand and aren't explained. When it's just a little offbeat and something's weird, but it's not so overwhelming, everything starts getting really funny. And not ha-ha funny. A lot of these use metaphors or striking imagery to get their point across. I love when everybody can walk away with a different idea of what they just watched, whether they hated it or loved it. FKA Twigs has some incredible concepts and just crazy visuals. The imagery that just hits you an element where every single frame looks like a dang work of art. I think one of the best ones is the Chemical Brothers' Let Forever Be. The amount of planning this must have took is just mind-blowing. I don't even know how they made this. And then I found out it was the director of Eternal Sunshine, and I was like, okay, that makes sense. This is probably my favorite one. It just pushes any boundaries. I love coming to the end of something and being like, what was that? But later I'm thinking about it, those images are just stuck in my head because I've never seen them before. A lot of indie songs do this. A lot of things that don't really need the commercial push of a regular music video. It doesn't work for every artist. It's gonna be harder to sell if you're a huge pop star. But there's some that still make this happen and it pays off big time. You watch one of these videos and the YouTube comments are probably like 0% girls, 0% guns, 0% cursing, 100% talent. And you're like, oh, so this video is gonna be boring. Nah, I'm just kidding. But all jokes have some truth to them. Not that one, no. And the last one is vibes. Basically just showing everybody having a good time, man. Loving every minute of it. Get You combines vibes and performance by showing the performer and then cutting away to the crowd and how they're feeling it. I feel like if I made music videos, which is something I want to do eventually, this is one I would kill, dude. I know how to cultivate a vibe. Alright, and I feel like I know how to make the viewer feel the same way. So yeah, I just wanted to make a video talking about music videos. These are my two favorite things put in one, man. Film and music in one thing. Who made this? What about you? What are some of your favorite music videos, or do you not like them at all? Let me know in the comments down below. There's a kajillion videos out there, so I couldn't say every single one of them, but I already know somebody's commenting like, I can't believe you missed the Crazy Frog video. That video changed my life. Well, check again, because he's in the first 2 seconds of this video. I don't miss. Things are just a little funny, and not ha ha funny.